Welcome to the Spirit Transmitter instructional video. All controls of the Spirit are done via an easy-to-use display and keypad. Adjustment of the external controls is performed on an individual basis by the physician, caregiver, or patient as necessary. The Spirit is fully compatible with existing patients' implants and antennas. Keypad and display. The keypad contains 12 keys. Keys that are enabled generate a notifier sound to alert that the key press was acknowledged. The notifier sound is a short beep played from an internal speaker. The visual alarms have an LED indicator on the keypad overlay below the display. The following are the keys. Key 0 increases the left side amplitude. Key 1 decreases the left side amplitude. Key 2 is for Avery technician use only. The lock key locks and unlocks the keypad. Key 3, when pressed and held for 2 seconds, turns the left side output on or off. Key 4 increases the respiratory rate. Key 5 decreases the respiratory rate. Key 6, when pressed and held for 2 seconds, turns the right side output on or off. Key 9 increases the right side amplitude. Key 8 decreases the right side amplitude. The backlight key activates the LCD backlight. And key 7 temporarily mutes the alarms. Keys 0 through 7 will have no effect unless the keypad is unlocked by pressing and holding the lock key for a minimum of 3 seconds. The graphics display shows all the relevant stimulation parameters as follows. Respiratory rate, right and left amplitudes, right and left battery charge status, right and left antenna connection icon, right and left RF signal indicating that the antenna is transmitting signal, alarm icon, keypad lock icon indicating that the keypad is locked, parameter mode icon, mode 1 is factory standard, and the mute icon, showing that the alarm is temporarily muted. During the inspiratory period, 3 curved lines above the left and right antenna icons will appear. This signifies that the antennas are transmitting a signal. During the expiratory period, the 3 lines are no longer present above the antenna icons. No signal is being transmitted. Batteries and silicone case. Ensure that the Spirit transmitter is turned off. Remove the silicone soft case, which protects the transmitter against water splashes, shock, or vibration. Insert 4 new alkaline batteries, 2 for each side. Do not use rechargeable batteries. Locate and open the battery compartment and remove the battery compartment door. The L and R on the labels indicate each side, and the positive marker on the battery symbols indicate the proper direction. Insert 2 alkaline batteries on the top row of the battery compartment. These batteries control the left side of the transmitter. Repeat for the bottom row. These control the right side of the transmitter. Replace the battery compartment door, bottom first, and snap it back into place. Follow these same steps when batteries need to be replaced, again ensuring that the Spirit transmitter is turned off. The system constantly monitors the battery voltage, and the icons on the display give a precise level of the battery charge of each side. The battery icon shows up to 4 bars depending on the charge level, as follows. Battery charge between 75% and 100%. Battery charge between 50% and 74%. Battery charge between 25% and 49%. Battery charge between 10% and 24%. And battery charge less than 10%. Once the batteries are inserted, you may now place the Spirit back into the silicone soft case. After the batteries are inserted, when both sides, left and right, are turned off, the respiratory rate, the battery, the lock, and mode icons will be displayed. With the spirit in one hand and the antenna connector in the other hand, align the half-moon-shaped guide inside the antenna connector with the flat surface of the half-moon-shaped guide inside the spirit socket. When properly positioned, the two half-moon guides form a whole circle. Press the antenna connector directly into the spirit socket until it clicks into place. Do not turn to lock antenna into place. Repeat for the other side. Do not rotate the metal plug when it is in the spirit socket. To remove antennas when the spirit is not in use, turn the device off, firmly hold the spirit with one hand, and grasp the antenna only by the rough collar or barrel of the metal plug. Holding the connector, pull it straight out. Do not pull on the wire or its rubber covering, and do not twist it or force it to disconnect.
Establishing threshold. Regardless of patient diagnosis, determination of each hemidiaphragm threshold is required prior to the start of effective bilateral diaphragm pacing. Threshold is the lowest amplitude setting that causes muscular contraction. The procedure to determine threshold amplitudes is as follows. Insert 4 new batteries into the spirit. Use only alkaline batteries. Do not use rechargeable batteries. Turn off both sides of the spirit by pressing the power on-off buttons on the keypad. Connect the left and right antennas carefully into the corresponding sockets marked patient left and patient right. Turn on the left side by pressing the left power on-off key. The spirit output starts at 300. Adjust the amplitude on the left side to 300 by pressing the up arrow key. Ensure that the left antenna is properly positioned over the receiver sight, firmly affixed with adhesive tape or other snug dressing. If required, pre-oxygenate patient as needed, then discontinue alternate means of ventilation. To determine the threshold, starting at 300, slowly increase the amplitude by pressing the left up arrow key until the smallest diaphragm contraction is observed while the three-wave icon on the display is visible. Threshold is the lowest stimulus amplitude to produce the smallest contraction of the diaphragm. It can be observed in one or more of the following ways. A. Patient reports appropriate sensation. B. Manual palpation. C. Observation of abdominal expansion. D. Respirometer. E. Fluoroscopy. Patient reporting and manual palpation are the simplest methods. Stimulation occurs when the three-wave icon over the antenna icon appears. Inspiratory period. When the three-wave icon disappears, expiratory period, there is no stimulation. Once the threshold has been determined for the left side, thoroughly ventilate the patient as needed. Turn off the left side of the spirit and repeat the above procedure, starting at step 4, to determine threshold for the right side. Amplitude adjustment. After determining the threshold on the left and right sides, the optimal amplitudes need to be determined. In general, the higher the amplitude, the larger the diaphragm contraction. Turn on both sides of the spirit. Starting at threshold amplitudes, gradually increase the amplitudes on the left and right side by pressing the up arrow keys until the patient achieves optimal tidal volume and diaphragm contraction without feeling discomfort. If the patient feels discomfort, lower the amplitudes while still maintaining optimal diaphragm contraction and tidal volume. If this cannot be achieved, call Avery Customer Service. Tidal volumes on the right are often larger than volumes on the left because of size difference between the two lungs. The breathing rate is set to provide the minute volume required by the patient. Minute volume equals breathing rate times tidal volume. The breathing rate is factory set at 12 BPM and should be adjusted to provide adequate ventilation dependent on the tidal volume obtained and the minute volume requirement of the patient. Pacing. Proceed with pacing until diaphragm fatigue appears. In newly implanted patients, this may vary. 5 minutes to 5 hours are both normal. Check blood gases periodically. Non-invasive pulse oximetry and either capnography or transcutaneous CO2 monitoring is suggested. Each day, resume pacing until fatigue occurs. For patients who obtain little or no tidal volume when stimulation is first initiated, diaphragm reconditioning must be performed. Effective retraining of the diaphragm can only take place if the spirit can stimulate at the same time with the patient's ventilator, so the hemidiaphragms can be exercised by contracting under pressure. Please refer to the instruction manual or contact Avery Biomedical's customer service for more information about diaphragm reconditioning.
Alarms. The spirit transmitter indicates alarm conditions through two types of alarms: sound alarms and visual alarms. If an antenna is disconnected from the transmitter while the corresponding side is still turned on, the speaker will beep, the LED indicator flashes, the corresponding antenna icon flashes, and the alarm icon turns on. If the antenna wire is damaged or broken, creating either an open circuit or a short circuit, the speaker will beep, the LED indicator flashes, the corresponding antenna icon flashes, and the alarm icon turns on. This condition can be intermittent. If the battery charge of one of the battery groups is below 8%, the speaker beeps, the LED indicator flashes, the corresponding battery outline flashes, and the fault icon turns on. Although the batteries may still have some remaining power, it is advisable to immediately replace them. If there is an internal device error, the speaker beeps, the LED indicator flashes, and the fault icon may or may not turn on. In order for the internal device error condition to be recovered, please do the following. Remove all batteries. Wait 15 seconds. Insert the batteries again. If they are not new, install 4 fresh batteries. Check the display. If audible and visual alarms are resolved, the spirit recovered from the alarm condition and the amplitudes and respiratory rate may need to be adjusted to previous settings. If this alarm persists, please contact the Avery Biomedical Devices Customer Service Department. All alarms can be temporarily muted for 30 seconds. Unlock the keypad and press the F key. The mute icon will appear, signifying that the alarm has been muted. After 30 seconds, it will disappear and the alarm will sound again. It may take a few seconds until an alarm is acknowledged or cleared. What to do in case of alarm? Verify the antenna connector is properly inserted into the spirit socket. If not, insert it properly until a click is heard. Check to ensure that the antenna loop is centered over the receiver. Check if the antenna needs to be replaced. Check the capacity of the batteries on each side. If the left or the right battery icon shows just the outline with no bars, the batteries on that side are depleted. Replace both batteries with new ones of the same type. If none of the above steps clears the alarm, please contact the Avery Biomedical Devices Customer Service Department. Troubleshooting. Use the following troubleshooting procedure if either the patient cannot start diaphragm pacing or had previously paced effectively and is experiencing a loss of or significant reduction in tidal volume. Check the battery icons on the display to determine if battery replacement is required. Check if both sides are on. Check if the right and left three-wave icons on the display are on during inspiratory periods. If the display alarm icon, sound, and LED alarms are active, a problem has occurred. The batteries may be low or the antennas may be defective. Replace the antenna with a new antenna. If the alarm condition disappears, the antenna was defective. Discard the defective antenna. If the batteries and antennas check out as fully functional and there are no alarms but pacing is not possible, see if effective pacing can be restored at a slightly increased amplitude setting. The patient may be experiencing a temporary increase in pacing threshold, thereby making the current spirit amplitude settings ineffective or too weak to pace. Effective pacing can be restored in a patient experiencing a temporary increase in threshold. However, a further increase in tidal volume will not be possible if the patient is experiencing diaphragm fatigue. If the patient had been pacing effectively prior to the loss of or significant reduction in tidal volume, place the patient on mechanical ventilation for 72 hours before restarting the pacing program. Call your physician and Avery Biomedical Devices customer service if large amplitude adjustments fail to restore effective diaphragm pacing. Check for infection often indicated by fever, pain, redness, or swelling anywhere in the body. Experience has shown that diaphragm pacing may become ineffective when the patient has any type of infection in any location. Infections may not always be evidenced by fever, but an abnormal white blood cell count may be noted. Treat any infection immediately. Pacing at slightly increased amplitude settings may be effective during treatment for infection. Otherwise, the patient may require mechanical ventilation. Be sure that the patient has not suffered any injury or accident that may have caused mechanical damage to implanted system components. If none of these circumstances apply, contact Avery Biomedical Devices customer service. Feel free to visit www.averybiomedical.com for more information or contact us at any time at our facility in Commack, New York. Thank you for your interest in the Avery Diaphragm Pacing System.